So far in our project development, we've created a new project, created some device profiles in the profile editor, and exported them into our project folder. The next logical step is to add devices to our project database. That is, we'll take a profile and apply our device's name and address so we can communicate to it. Before we start this process, let's talk about your pre-work. You should have some kind of network diagram or address spreadsheet containing your device names and their addresses. If you don't have this handy, we'll look at an example in an upcoming video. For now, however, assume that I know my device name and address. I'll begin with my Topology tab and select I/O Devices. Here, I can access the I/O Device Manager, which, as the name implies, manages my device databases. The first dialog here gives me an overview of the devices already in my project. Be sure to have your correct project selected in this view. The two buttons below let me either add or remove a single device or use a CSV file to bulk manage my devices. I'll manage a single device for now, but once we discuss using the CSV, that is definitely the preferred method for reasons that will be clear later. The next page starts my wizard to manage the device. Obviously, I can add or remove a device here, or if I've changed a device profile, I can update those devices already added. I'm going to add one device to my project. Here, I'll select the profile that defines the device I want to add. This list comes straight from that equipment.profiles file that we exported from the profile editor, including the categories and subcategories. For fun, I'll select my custom meter profile and click Next. Now we have some jargon from the database, an equipment name and an I/O device name. These are two different names for the same device on the network. The I/O device name is the low-level name that is used in the database to reference the different tags. It has a 16-character limit by default. The equipment name is generally more human-readable and is also used to define an equipment hierarchy. I can create different levels in my hierarchy by separating them with periods so that devices can be grouped together by site, building, area, or switchgear. Here, I'll have a group of meters called LV metering, and within that group, there's a meter called DT1 light. This will make more sense once we get into the web HMI. Note that both fields allow only underscores as special characters. Below this is a field with other options used in the profile. These can vary depending upon the type of profile, but they all allow me to override the graphics builder component set in the profile editor. This will be more clear when we get to the graphics editor, but the first value is the type of equipment this is in the one-line diagram, and the rest of the fields navigate to the graphics component in our library. The remaining dialogues vary depending on the driver used in the selected profile. This is a Modbus meter, so I can choose to communicate to it with Modbus TCP or through a serial gateway. Next, I'll enter the IP address of my device and its Modbus address. Since this is a Modbus TCP device, I can get away with just using 255 as my address. We'll look at the port later, but in general, I recommend leaving this name at the default unless you have some reason to change it. Finally, we can add our device to the database. I can check to continue adding equipment or finish. As my last point, I can now remove my device by selecting it from the list of devices in my database. In a large project, this list can be very long. At this point, I have a device added to my database. And when I compile and run the project, I'll be able to communicate to it. Unfortunately, there's more setup required for me to be able to prove that to you, so I'll leave you with an option. The next few videos will explore the device management process further, but you may also jump ahead to the graphics editor section to set up the web HMI and verify your data using the Live Data tool. Whichever way you choose, thank you.